Okay, so there's a thing in science that we like to call thermodynamics. Now that sounds like a really strange, complicated word, but essentially, thermodynamics is it's a branch of physics that deals with energy and the work of a system. It's the study of the relationship among heat, work, temperature, and energy. You have the first law of thermodynamics, you have the second law, you have the third law. But wait, you can actually go back before the first law and you have the zeroth law. It's not a theory. It's not, hey, this might be what happens, or I think maybe this happened if that could have happened. These are laws. And of course we know that laws are observable. They're testable. They're repeatable. That's kind of how science works. The first law is all about the conservation of energy. See, it basically tells us that energy cannot be created or destroyed. It's always a constant. It's fixed, it's set. So energy can't just appear out of nowhere. Then the second law of thermodynamics actually tells us that entropy will increase in a system. Well, you may be surprised to hear that things do not get better with time. Things do not get better with time. Things do not get better with time. They get worse. They get worse. They actually get worse. They fall apart. For example, planets will actually cool down. Gravitation pull actually weakens. Things generally fall apart. I mean, check out your hair when you wake up in the morning. Let's think about it. Does the pavement on the highway actually get better? Does the unattended garden actually blossom? Does an unwashed fat man on the beach start to smell better? Does a wrecked car have the ability to heal itself? If only I could think of a good example to show you guys how entropy works. Like, I don't know, a building? Or better yet, when you get to your 20-year high school reunion, go to the nearest mirror and check that out. Now you may be surprised to learn that in the book of Psalms, chapter 102, God talks about laying down the foundations of the heaven and the earth, and how those foundations will eventually wax old like a garment. You can also find it in Isaiah 51, verse 6, and then of course in Hebrews chapter 1, verse 10 through 12, talks about the same thing. So God, in His Word, actually tells us about the physical creation and about how over time everything's going to get worse. It's going to wear down. It's going to die. You see, in the beginning, God created everything and it was perfect. And He put man in charge of everything. And then like man always does, he messes things up. Yeah, we're pretty good at that. Now once man fell from grace, it messed up everything. But it also messed up everything that we're in charge of, like the physical creation. And so, we are growing old and falling apart. The creation is growing old and falling apart. This is what the Bible tells us. Now, of course, if you're one of those Big Bang people, or perhaps you're an evolutionist, or maybe even an atheist, more than likely you'd be all of those. Well, that thought process wants us to think that everything came from nothing. That in the beginning there was nothing, and that nothing somehow exploded. And then, of course, through subsequent millions and millions of years of evolution, things get better. So somehow it miraculously organized itself into all kinds of amazing things, like our solar system, like living matter, like Jell-O pudding. So thermodynamics is awesome! It's what a lot of us might like to call scientific. It forces me to conclude that we have two camps. In the one camp, we have biblical Christianity. But over here in the other camp, we have those that oppose biblical Christianity, and that's things like evolution, atheism, the Big Bang. Now, when I look at the laws of thermodynamics, the observable, repeatable, testable laws, I would have to admit that one of these two camps actually lines up with real science. But if only I could figure out which one it is. Yeah.